He did perform okay on that Renekton with teleport last time around. And CLG have been working with him to improve their early game as well as his champion pool. So we'll have to see if that comes into play here, because when he first came over, it was pretty much all about Shyvana. He has dipped into the Aurelia, but it hasn't been as impressive.
AD carry is getting a little bit focused out here, and Lucian is the first one. We saw towards the end of the split that Doublelift and Aphromoo would pick up Lucian and Thresh. Even after Doublelift stated many times that Lucian probably wasn't an AD carry that he'd play at the beginning of the split. Now it's one of those top AD carries. Eve getting banned out as well. Been seeing quite a bit of her from the likes of the junglers in the NALCS, as the bans are going a little bit slower than our games today.
Yeah, the big jungler left up here, as you know, they answer the Lee Sin ban with an Evelynn ban, is that Elise. Both these junglers really do like that champion, and with two bans spent on that position already, that might be a contested very early pick here for these guys.
Yasuo. Broken Shard does love that Jarvan. Maybe Snoopy opened the window for him. Bring it back out. We'll see Westrice getting a pick in here. Like you said, the Elise is open. Last time, they picked up for Mancloud, I believe, to make it safe. No, I'm wrong. They did not. They left for Mancloud. But he was a focus during the game. Really hurt his Nidalee play. He tried to go for poke. Most of the team kind of forming around him last time. So they're taking Mancloud's play as a sub into consideration and almost building around him.
Yeah, they could very well go back to the Nidalee. It's always good to take away Nidalee from CLG. That was Link's original champion, Seraph as well, actually. But I would expect Complexity to go more early game oriented. Okay. Looks like they will not, and they're going to go with that poke. So it is going to be up to Broken Shard, because Nidalee really thrives when you get an early lead. If she can get to the point where even just an Athena's and Holy Grail, if you have control of blue buffs, she can start sieging up and throwing spears pretty much as soon as she gets a single item.
Something to lock down those long-range pokers. Thresh is still alive. I'd be very surprised to see that go through the hands of Aphromoo. Could be the Morgana, though. Still very good pickup. Has been getting a lot more play on the support scene, and it will be locked in. So CLG is kind of shying away from their wheelhouse picks here.
It's really good picks. The interesting thing to me here is a first pick Nidalee. You're thinking, oh, wow, you're going to need some hard engage to get that, to that Nidalee. You're also going to need maybe a very strong jungler to go for counter jungling, trying to take advantage of Nidalee's weak early lane phase. CLG lock in some skill shot poke of their own here.
Yeah.
The sort of Cloud 9 combo, really long crowd control timers with short cooldowns. If they both build cooldown reduction, Morgana and Elise can lock up a front line very quickly. So both teams actually going with the sort of long range poke game here right out of the gate.
That could absolutely be Mancloud's Kha'Zix for mid lane. See the Nidalee go somewhere else. No, I'm just kidding.
Could
just
be. Yeah, it could be a top lane Nidalee. You don't have to backtrack there, Rib.
True.
That's a valid.
This is true. Well, no, I was actually kidding. But we don't really see Westrice play those type of champions.
Yeah, it could happen though. Westrice is a wild card.
Yep. Broken Shard locking in the Corki for Robert X Lee. Getting a lot of love on that from Sneaky and Alltech lately with plays to Corki. So he's going to try his hand at it. Good amount of time being utilized here by the teams as they go through picks and bans.
Yeah, and it adds more poke damage. Coming from an AD carry, Corki with those long-range missiles is one of the few that can add a lot of decent poke for your team as well, while remaining a very mobile and safe champion. Just all around pretty good, solid pick nowadays that Lucian is banned out, and people have started to shy away from Twitch now that everybody's starting to avoid getting picked off. More pink wards and traveling in groups has increased the risk of using Twitch and decreased the reward.
Oh, the Sivir gets brought back out. Something Doublelift brought in the other day, if you remember, kind of praising himself after the boomerang kill in top lane in the all chat exercise.
Well,
be a great
it was impressive.
It was impressive.
Talking about AD carries with poke, Boomerang Blade is a perfect example. Both these teams have very strong long-range options so far. The only thing is that CLG probably have the upper hand in picking people off.
Yeah.
Not only do they have all these options with bindings and cocoons and LeBlanc burst, but they've got the Sivir speed to add on top of all those options, so they can move around very quickly to take advantage of mispositionings from Complexity. So if CLG get an early lead with this team and get wards down, should be pretty easy for them to maneuver and start picking people off.
I mean, if you look at just kind of the four members CLG has picked up already, those are some of the highest priority picks that they would put in their own hands. So, wow, CLG is already going to give Complexity a tough time coming into this game. I feel like they're somewhat playing from behind here with Dexter getting a lease, Link on that LeBlanc, Doublelift, knowing the AD carry so well and just deciding to go for Sivir with even others open.
And that is a bold support pick for Bubba Dub. Every time I've ever seen LeBlanc and Zyra in the same game on teams, it usually ends with Zyra getting 100%ed sometime around the mid-game. So Bubba Dub going to have to watch his positioning here.
I'm actually...
Zyra is a prime target for LeBlanc.
Remembering some Faker plays from Worlds, and it's literally a Zyra on the other end of his LeBlanc.
Yeah, because she builds a lot of AP, and she's a support champion that does not get very beefy. Usually a very easy target there in the mid-game for LeBlanc.
Well, looks like we could have Seraph locking in the Jax. It's one of his staple champions. He'll feel very comfortable on that. We've also seen him have back-and-forth lanes. He's been able to come back. He's been able to not dominate a lane, but take it evenly and help the team out for a controlled win. And they say communication is not an issue coming in with Seraph anymore. So everything should be going right as rain for CLG.
Yeah, they're proud with his ability to communicate. Yep. Now, picking up that Jax into a Renekton is very bold and definitely calls out that CLG are looking for lane swaps. Renekton, even with the nerfs early game, still is able to handle Jax very effectively. So CLG are definitely looking more towards the later stages of the game with this team. That's when Jax will start to shine. If he can get a good start, if he can get any little advantage over Renekton when they finally do meet up in lanes, then he will definitely have the split pushing advantage. It's up to Complexity to go for that early game. We may get to see, as they were talking about, early game aggression, crazy plays from Broken Shard specifically.
Would love to. Before the game gets underway, let's see how you've been voting over at LOLesports.com, where CLG leads Complexity with 88%.
And remember, you can continue sharing your predictions by tweeting either hashtag COLWin or CLGWin to @LOEsports. We'll check back with your votes throughout the game.
Going to be a tough game for the bottom lanes coming into this one. We'll have to see if Robert X Lee even matches up against Doublelift. If they decide to get that, probably Doublelift and Afro want that lane, seeing a Zyra on the other side. But I don't know if Robert X Lee is going to give it to him. We've seen if Robert can get an early lead, he has an AD carry that can hold it. So he may be able to give Doublelift a run for his money.
Yeah, I'm very interested in the early game here, the level one start for CLG, because, like I said, that Jax does not want to meet up with Renekton by himself. We'll have to see. Maybe they'll go with the scavenger-style jungling for him.
Broken Shard been quite confident about the situational control over how Complexity takes a game. I get into the jungle, I can kind of control everything, but he puts that before kind of figuring out when they're going to get into the jungle, when they're going to do it. And if you take those few steps too early, then you haven't looked before you leap, and it usually sets you back. We'll see if they can get the forward motion rolling here as we get into your third match of the day, Complexity versus Counter Logic Gaming. We're on the Rift.
I like the post-game interviews with Broken Shard too, because his answer is always, yeah, we were not playing aggressive enough. We need to try more things early game.
Keep going. Pedal to the metal. Slow rolling out of the base. No sweepers. A few extra wards for Sight. Oh, gosh. That's Broken Shard. Didn't level something. He was thinking about leveling. Oh, he gets caught. Boomerang could be
gold.
There. Seraph, no stun.
He's got all
stun.
His procs on the spell thief.
They know where Corki is. So they got Broken Shard out of this one. Jungle control, lockdown.
Afro's rich man.
Oh, double lift. Boop. Oh, dodge it. He is. They're gonna toy with.
Still.
They're gonna toy. Here comes the dark binding. Afro
move.
Oh, he pushed him. No way. No way. CLG.
Now they're cornered. Hunter, though, look, they're in enemy territory. Can they get out, or is Mancloud going to pick up a kill?
Oh, Huff it. No. Oh, the distraction from Doublelift. He says his shoes are untied. Mancloud looks. Now goes for Doublelift. Dexter coming from the right side. They could easily close this down. Seraph has to be careful. He is in a dangerous spot. Doublelift is not going to like this situation. Wait a minute. No. They're going to come out big on this.
Right.
That's the barrier coming out. Mancloud goes down. No, the summoner heal. That's Doublelift going down. What is going on right now? 1 minute and 44 seconds. Robert X. Lee is going to finally waltz Seraph right out of the back door.
Wait, who was supposed to be crazy in this game, Riv? Was it supposed to be Complexity?
What?
It looks a little bit like CLGR. They pinned down Broken Shard, and they commit for this one. Afro goes real deep on this, turret damage stacking up on him, and Link takes two giant ones. Now, the turret damage stacked up on Afro, it still was stacked by the time it switched over to Link on LeBlanc, so he expected to take a little less damage from that second hit. Executes, though, not that bad for CLG. So
bing, bang, boom.
Only one of those kills actually giving money over to Complexity. And
wow.
We start this one off with a bang.
What a laning phase this creates. I don't know if anybody has their summoner spells up left. We got a few flashes on one side. CLG actually has the majority of flashes up, so some early plays maybe to still be made on their 500 gold lead. They definitely broke the ice on this one. See if they can keep the lane.
Some shenanigans over there at the blue buff. Looks like Bubba Dub was trying to interrupt Dexter, but they just scared him off. Everything's fine. He's got his double buffs, and Seraph actually going to let him get that level 3 spike without sharing experience. It's something we did see in the last game too, letting the junglers hit that level by standing a little bit further away so they can get an extra spell and increase the duo's jungling speed.
Oh,
for an early gank here. Pings come out, though. Good ward.
Yeah. Very good ward. Mancloud hovering the top side of the mid lane.
Ooh, wasted time here. The clock is ticking.
Oh, man.
And this is not just jungler wasted time. This is two members of CLG. Broken Shard tags him there now.
Oh. Win on that ward. Westrice coming out on top. We got a smirk on him. Oh, wow. Bubba Dub with the roam here. We're going to see what has to happen. Looks like they should be able to get out safe. Dexter using the last minion he sees to get himself in a safe repel. But they're drawing out of lane here. This is experience. Aphromu and Doublelift are grabbing. That was a roam by Bubba Dub. See what happens here as these lanes are getting kind of strung out.
Yeah, I don't know if I agree with that tag. If they're waiting there looking for a gank and you have vision of them, it's usually best to just let them wait there and see how much of their time you can waste.
It's a good point.
There's not much, not much real damage he was going to get with that harass. And they could have just kept on jungling, trying to increase their lead a little bit. But all comes out even so far.
Some ferocious wolves. Westrise keeping himself alive. Called the Meek with a little bit of heal. You can see Mancloud having a bit of trouble farming in that mid lane as he gets pushed up to his turret. About a 10 CS lead as Broken Shard is looking to relieve that pressure. They want to be able to get Mancloud going this game. And there's the distortion used. They couldn't have asked for more. Link is on the right side to make the walk out here. Broken Shard with red buff. It looks like they're just going to waltz this one out.
Ooh.
Good movement by Link.
Yeah, he actually gets a good summoner spell trade there. Ignite 4 barrier, even with the gank from Broken Shard. And Mancloud missing the cannon minion after is actually pretty big.
Could have been a better chase on that, but we gotta remember that early engagement, all these flashes down, not a lot of early vision coming in from the teams. So Mancada and Broken Shard still holding strong in mid, trying not to go down.
Westrise.
Top lane.
Now, I talk about the scavenging style top laners nowadays. It's not just in the jungle. If you can get to your turret and just pick up experience from the minions that are close, then it's a pretty big win, but it's very dangerous. Westrice here.
There's one slice. Nice.
Pretty good escape.
Just wait for him to get as close as you can and make your move. Turret damage to come in, as well as denial of all of this experience. Moving into the jungle is going to be Dexter and Doublelift trying to keep it safe on the white. And it looks like Complexity still Bubba Dub roaming around. They're putting a lot on stopping just the simple invades from CLG.
I'd like the call from CLG to come get Wes Rice out from under the turret so that he is not able to gain that experience. Yeah. They zoned him off for another wave there. But Complexity now backing him up with extra support here as Bubba Dub continues to roam. Robert X. Lee has been all by himself down in that bottom lane.
This is going to be big, especially if Bubba Dub keeps being this far away from everything. Level 6 for Zyra is huge, especially objective control. And once Afremu and the rest of the team hit that, they're going to be well off in a fight over Complexity. Broken Shard backing. He'll get himself some regular items to get himself back in the game. Just picking up a stone. Mancloud trying to put pressure on in mid to the level 6s. You can see Bubba Dub just in the end, level 3.
And talking about picking up experience at turrets, Seraph actually gets to the bottom turret just in time for CLG. That wave that Altec has been nurturing down there just crashes into the turret. So this is going to be some much-needed experience for Seraph to actually catch up. Since Wes Rice got the first kill, as well as just being Renekton, Seraph does not want to meet up with him anytime soon. And needs all the help he can get.
And then look at Seraph and how much control they just allow him to have. But look at Wes Rice, he's almost going down. Double lift, not too much vision. Past the turret, whoa, going in strong. Puts on the spell shield and the black shield. Gets out safely, very good combination to keep themselves alive.
It's also still got flash and heal, so they might be able to bait here. Broken Shard actually just backs off though.
I was saying in the bottom lane just before the engage, they haven't really given much to Seraph. Dexter's not worried about going down there. He's fine against Corki, and that's almost been, you know, from game to game. Seraph does his own thing, and then CLG calls on him when they need.
And the regular blue buff respawn there for both guys is actually pretty good for Complexity. They really want to be able to control the next one as well. So we'll be looking at that 5 minutes into the future for third spawn of blue buffs. Because that's when it would be up to Dexter and Link to really make their move. LeBlanc and Elise combo is one of the best combos at going for those blue buff respawn cutoff ganks where you try and intercept the enemy mid laner. If they get the vision control around your blue buff, then it's very dangerous for you to try and go into that combo.
And it's safe still. Link. A little frustrated that you can't finalize these kills. Mancloud's playing it safe. Well, that's exactly what you want to do. Back and forth, just to pepper him off with his minions. Trying to stay in range of the CS experience with Seraph in a very tricky situation here. He's got good ward behind him, which allows him to stay here for now. Robert X. Lee at 74. Looking to double lift 73, so not too much of a difference between the AD carries.
And a lot of these teams have been making this adaptation to send their support part of the time to help out the top laner rather than the AD carry. Once the AD carry gets a significant amount of farm in the early game, just leaving them at a turret to freeze it. Double F has complete control of the wave up in top lane, so he can keep it in a safe spot. And that allows Afremu to freely roam and create plays here. He might get himself into trouble, though. As Broken Shard looks to defend his pink ward.
Good call there. Ethereal Chain getting the lockdown.
Number two.
Early Chalice from Mancloud, stopping a good amount of that damage. But Link also hasn't really put any ability power under his belt either. Just harassing with the blue buff for now. Mancloud working the fog of war on the outside. Both teams giving a good amount of respect to each other here. CLG only the 900 gold lead. They're not really trying to activate too much with it. Complexity, however, goes to Dragon Attempt.
Well, a lot of that gold lead and the experience lead that CLG have right now are coming from that top lane where Doublelift was freezing it. So Complexity make the correct decision to try and force something, make Doublelift unfreeze the lane in response to that dragon. And Wes Rice looks to capitalize here. He's probably going to get at least a summoner out of Doublelift.
Maybe. Slice of dice to come up. Dominus is still on. He decides not to go as he's about to lose his ultimate as well. Doublelift makes it out alive. Look how calm, cool, and collected he was. He's like, assess the situation, calculate it, and I'm actually going to stay to farm.
Not even scared of the dive from Wes Rice.
But Wes Rice, he's coming back now. Got to remember there's a spell shield onto him. Yeah, he's not going to decide to go hard under the turret. The greed is clean with this one. 2-1, 11 minutes in. Still just the Farm Fest in the mid lane, the Farm Fest to the bottom lane. We did see that Robert X Lee was able to wholly take down Cloud9, but that was after a very big advantage in the bottom lane. When he's not given that, Doublelift's really able to take advantage there. We talked about Doublelift and Aphromoo, one of the best duos out there.
Doublelift is feeling pretty good about his situation right now because he got alone time up in that top lane. Yeah. CLG basically traded focused farm on him, and he did end up getting the turret, so even that global gold of Dragon balanced out there. Really the difference is that he has a completed Bloodthirster because of the focused gold onto him, rather than Robert X Lee with just the pieces of Bloodthirster.
There's a good dodge on the Counter-Strike, but that's still Grandmaster is on, forcing the flash. They're getting everything they want. Action across the map, now down to the other side. Bubbadub taking a quick Phosphorus in the early damage. It's usually the only time you go straight for the support on the engage. Zyra's going down fast.
And that skirmish up in the top lane. Something I really like that Crumbs has been doing is the flash cocoons.
Oh, wow. Boomerang, not enough. It wasn't calculated that time.
Gets the heal out.
Yep. Uh-oh. Diving in. This should be a pretty good escape. You got the slow on the first part of it, and they're not able to get enough consecutive crowd control down after that. The turret's low. So it looks like they're going to lose it here, but they'll see what they can do. West Rice is down for 11 more seconds. No dragon up for any time soon, so the map is just kind of clearing out now. Nice little fights in both top and bottom lane.
Let's take a look at what happened to West Rice, buddy up here. See how Seraph is progressing, because flashing in for the stun, okay. So they burned his flash and just a repeat gank. Good call from Dexter. A good setup as well from Seraph. Top lane jungler combo there, taking advantage of West Rice having no turret and no vision.
See, he'll take out this pink ward. He pinged it for Link. Very nicely done. Dexter's going to be waltzing out with that one. And that's the control. Dexter said once he can make it in, he's going to be able to control the game. Very definitive player that he has that list he wants to check off and make things happen. You know, CLG isn't a team to allow you to come.
Yeah, I mean, we talked about Dexter with the plans that he comes into with the games. His AD carry, Doublelift, was already in a very good situation because Doublelift got a lane up there to farm, so he was going to be fine down bottom. Really only question was this scaling Jax. They wanted to get him going.
There's a big empower shot right there, waiting on the cooldowns. If Seraph turns around, they could easily take down West Rice, but never mind. Nidalee coming in, Mancloud from the side, much needed kill. I was going to say kills, but they only get one there. The shutdown.
Great roam from Complexity. They do need to get some turret damage or something, though, because right now they've got, again, Doublelift farming a lane deep in his own territory, and mid lane is being shoved by Link, trying to punish Mancloud for that roam. He just barely gets into the turret, though. Whoa, Dexter!
Got to be careful. He still has the rappel left. West Rice is going in hard. He's drawing it. They've done this more than once. Falsely getting them into where they want. West Rice with a nice dodge, but that's the Dark Binding and Cocoon combination that has been so much loved by
team. Everyone's four!
Very
He's
close.
Got the slow, though. He hit the slow.
No flash up.
Can he hit it?
It's the Q.
It's a fairly long-range, slow-moving projectile.
Broken Shard using the rearview mirrors to stay safe.
Good juke. Nice spear for Mancloud. They might actually be the ones to come out ahead on turrets with this exchange.
Mancloud, uh-oh. This could actually be really bad. He could go down here. Very safe play. The rest of the team doing what they can to keep Mancloud alive. Link just on the edge of being able to kill him. The rest of CLG now groups into the mid lane. They want to start taking control.
Yeah, good pressure from Complexity. Actually draws, again, Doublelift out of the farming lane that he was in bottom.
Moving back, slowing things down. Everybody knows it's been a little hectic so far. 1 minute on the Dragon, so we're going to get backs from the majority of CLG right now as they were on Complexity's side of the map. They've taken what they need, and now they get themselves ready. It's Broken Shard. He's going to take up red.
Let's see if Complexity can actually do anything with this next Dragon spawn, because they do have the advantage in teleport cooldown. So if they actually manipulate the lanes right, and West Rice is able to get distance from Seraph, they can force something down around the next dragon. They can get a man advantage down there.
4-1-0 for Seraph. He's built for a dragon fight. the Cutlass and the Sheen for mid-game damage.
And Complexity really, really do need that. So they've actually got two members of CLG up top. This would be perfect. If Websites just backs off, they don't have vision of him. There's no way CLG can contest that dragon down bottom. He doesn't even have to teleport here. I don't know why. Complexity are actually worried about the collapse of three members of CLG.
Good hit onto Mancloud. The teleport comes in. This now leaves Seraph in the top lane. The teleport's his to bring to the fight. CLG kind of gets an upper hand here on movement. Actually, I'm sorry. Seraph's teleport is down as I look up there now. So he's going to have to make the long haul or decide for the turret.
So they do end up teleporting him down. They don't get a kill. The dragon's a little bit later than they would have liked. Yeah. They're still going to get it, but Westrise really needs to be able to stop this split pushing Jax because Seraph is getting out of control. They did get the dragon objective, though.
Yep.
Pretty big pickup.
Turret damage. Another wave coming in right behind him. Oh, he does have to back off. That's going to cost him some precious time. We'll see Link. A little sketchy in his positioning here, but he thinks he can zero out. That Zyra still looking for Bub Dub, like you said.
Yeah, Link may have been the key factor in why Complexity just didn't rush that dragon to begin with. Because the threat of that blue buff at the time, a LeBlanc, one-shotting people on the outside was just too scary for them.
Westrise eats a Cutlass. Still damage going through, just not an effect to be added. You see Alphramu taking a big chunk there. Doublelift has to watch his right flank. Very, very close, but the wards keeping him very safe right now. He's able to get the early game damage, or early damage on that initiation. And 1,000 gold lead for Complexity right now. They're definitely needing to use this, because they're on their heels at the moment.
I have to see if they can actually keep up this defensive ward line, because he said that's going to be very important for them. Still, CLG looking to roam around and pick people off. As Complexity move into CLG's side of the jungle, they do lose out on a lot of that vision that they have on the side lanes here.
Still have to remember at the beginning of the game we mentioned Aphramuz taking a bit more control in champ select, Link a bit more control on the in-game calls. Right now that's kind of the split and try to spread Complexity out thin. As CLG gains control of the map.
So they're doing right now, not only are they split pushing Jax, but also using LeBlanc's assassination power to scare people away from that lane. They actually might go for a dive here as Dexter does come down, but Complexity can answer. Running straight up mid here. It's basically going to be a race. Two side lanes split pushing for CLG. And Complexity putting all of their eggs in the middle right here. It's a game of chicken. I feel like CLG are actually going to get the better of this. They have two side lanes pushing at once.
See, if Doublelift and Aphramu actually can't really get themselves towards the turret. They've been pushed off. I figured the Boomerang Blade and Tormented Soy would keep that alive. Seraph still doing work here on the top turret. He will take down the second tier himself. And the second tier in the bottom lane goes down. That is huge to be opened up right now.
They don't want to let him out either. Seraph teleports in.
It's going to be right in the middle. Not really finding too much of a pinch here. It looks like Robert actually is going to be able to stay safe. It's all about who's on his left side.
Sivir ulti is up. Does he want to pop the mobility? Just barely they get out of CLG's pincer.
It's happened quite a few times where both teams have just kind of stared at each other face to face and then backed off of the situation because they realize no one has the upper hand. They figured each other out and it would almost be a complete double ace to fight these. Very close on the gold still. CLG's pulled back the lead in their favor, seeing Link not do that. Sun was in his eyes. He's going to continue to try now at the mid. CLG is still getting some damage on the turret. A very nice disengage on the Stranglethorn. The heal goes up as well as the speed. Woo. Very close. Can't even see the health bar of Seraph right now.
Dexter, though, he's in trouble.
Oh, wait a minute. Fancy feed on Dexter. I think he could be able to make it out of this. Oh, he gets Mancloud on the pounce. Mancloud gets the brush. He's got the passive movement speed. Broken Shard is there. Void Spikes over the side. He has the minion. The spiders behind him. Dodges another one.
Oh, misses Cocoon, though.
This is going to be big. He's going for the long run. Right now, at this point, no, I guess he's not back to execution. He got hit by the Void Spike, so he's got some time. Still going hard. The final pounce, but he wasted a lot of time there.
It was only Mancloud that he was drawing out, though. So the rest of complexity actually make a pretty good call. They've got a split resources right now, trying to defend mid as well as take top turret for that. They can't defend mid. They can't take top either.
CLG finally getting what they want to open up the map on that middle lane turret. Again, grabbing themselves some vision and denying more to complexity. Seraph is still in the top lane. Kind of put him on an island. And then they bring, like I said, bring him out whenever they need him.
Early game went pretty well for CLG. As I was saying in Champion Selected, been able to avoid that Renekton versus Jax matchup. And coming in even farm now at 21 minutes, Seraph's finally confident that he can handle West Rice.
We'll see what happens. Big level up there for Broken Shard to get the resets. Get the right people in a fight. Definitely getting away with the right amount of gold. Slowly checking summoners. Still on West Rice. He's got his teleport up. Seraph has been hanging out in that lane. His complexity themselves are still trying to do a bit of a split, gain control. But right now, Broken Shard's in the back. They're kind of all sorts. Going to see if we can
get
Seraph in the top.
Everybody rotating up top to see if they can actually collapse on Seraph.
That's good damage coming out. That needlessly large rod pickup Mancloud just got is making an impact.
They will lose the base race, though.
That on the hunt also speeds up your minions, so you gotta be careful. Get them up to the turret faster as well. There's the Q coming out. Boomerang! Afro move! They can follow this! The entire team was ready! Complexity on the same page in a split second flash from Afro move over the wall to Dark Binding. Broken Shard looks to get hit. The Hex Drinker! That has been sated. The Thirst now shielding himself, and it looks like West Rice to come in huge here. CLG may have not been able to reassess the fight after they got their first kill, and Complexity starts to round things out.
Yeah, CLG miscalculate there. They overlook one important fact, the teleport for West Rice available. Seraph's was down. So meanwhile, you know, they got the jump on Mancloud. They got that play with the speed boost from Sivir. It was not on even ground, though, because Complexity have the extra man to come in. West Rice teleports in, saves the day for his team.
Oh.
You can't immediately reactivate the stun from Counter-Strike. So West Rice joining this party makes it go all downhill for CLG. Crocodile comes in to clean up. And Broken Shard barely dodging that binding because West Rice is such a large, large crocodilio.
Broken Shard also kissing his Hex Drinker, keeping him alive from the burst of Link and really initiating the rest of that fight with the power of everyone to keep running through. Complexity looking strong here as they start to stave off the pressure CLG puts on. They're second tier down in mid, so Complexity has the shortest lane to the base cleared out right now. What you got to remember, CLG has the outside lanes, and that's how CLG works in their rotations. They can really work the map. West Rice putting pressure in the top lane. Pings go to the middle. They actually don't want to try anything here. They want to be ready. They think CLG feels like they have the upper hand, and they're going to give them some room. See how much pressure they try to put on. Oh, Link just on the outside of that Grasping Root. That was so close.
Both teams fighting over vision now inside of CLG's jungle. The battlefield has turned right now. Blue buff smite fight does go to Complexity.
Smoted nicely.
Nope. Hit it with a rocket. He blew that shit up.
5-4 in turrets. Where are they going to go with this one? Should be down the mid lane, double lift. Actually, oh, they're pinging out West Rice right now. It looks like he has got himself caught out in La La Land here. And the entire team's going to be chasing, or they're going to set up to grab position knowing West Rice is out of position.
Pretty good loop, though. He's actually been able to sneak away. CLG don't get anything out of this, and Complexity have three lanes pushing right now. Mancloud is getting experience down in that bottom lane. He does pull away from it, but CLG at least got some vision control around Baron. Very, very scattered game plan here, and that's what happens when you have two teams with a lot of poke potential and picking power here. CLG really haven't been able to make the best of it so far, even with their mobility. Miscalculating things like teleport cooldowns has really cost them.
Good pink ward coverage.
Baron. They should be able to get this one. Westrise has no reason to go check Baron right now. Look at Complexity's vision control. It's the entire map except for Baron. Yeah. They feel safe. They've got so much vision on the map. But the crucial area, they're lacking in.
Yeah, it can help. Four pink wards, none of them with an eye on Baron. Big Brother not going to help this time. No! No, don't do that! All right, face check. This could be bad. Counter-Strike's about to hit. There is the Dominus coming on, but it's just too much front-end damage. The quick slowdown, the lockdown. Westrise gets hit up. The base is going to be open with a Baron up CLG.
Complexity thought of everything except for the inside the Baron pit. So many wards down, but none close enough to see the main target there. CLG taking a huge jump to get right back in this game. Now they can actually fight back. They can start clearing out some of these wards because Complexity have just dominated the map so far with vision.
Great move by Robert, actually quickly getting to the bottom lane. Not allowing CLG to grab too much after Baron. They had to get the waves cleared up. So Complexity doing the right things to stave off a lot of this pain, but they have to stop the bleeding. CLG now getting the gold back in their favor with the objectives. 2 minutes on Dragon. Looks like Complexity is going with the power in numbers right now as they keep grouping up.
A lot of CLG's money focused on Seraph, though. They focus a lot of their early ganks. They put all the kills on him. He's definitely going to have to be a very big part in the way that they finish off this game. If they don't work around their strong split-pushing Jax, it can crumble very quickly. Even though they have Baron buff, if Seraph gets picked off, if he's unable to join a fight once again, and it's a 4v5, then Complexity can still easily turn this one. However, they have been starting to fight back in those vision wars. And once CLG actually get control, then you have to worry about the combos we've been seeing. Dark Bindings into Cocoons, into LeBlanc pickoffs. A lot of damage sources here from CLG.
Got about 2 minutes left on Baron. Seraph feeling like he has the upper hand here. Takes Westrise down to half. Broken Shard actually does not want to keep going. The vision in their jungle is a little lackluster. Link walked right over that. Broken Shard's kind of trying to bait in another fight for these spears from Mandatory Cloud, and they're doing it right. There's the hit. Broken Shard gets it. He's going to try to keep walking this one out for Man Cloud. The heal to come in here, hopefully, keeps Broken Shard alive, and they are going to walk out. Base is taking damage.
At bottom, though, they lost an inhibitor turret for that chase.
Oh, my gosh. Westrise is big. Already used the Randuin, so they're not going to get extra slow out of that one. The damage is coming in. Double it, puts himself right near the front of the fight. Aframu with the Soul Shackle does not lock anybody down. Stays alive. The last hit, it comes from Dexter as he gets into the base. Another one from Double it, and the inhibitor is going to go down after this fight. All of this stemming from a top lane engage.
And we see the magnificent control that a Morgana and Elise combo gives you.
Yep.
When you add to that Sivir ultimate for speed, it's just a worst nightmare for Renekton.
Broken Shard getting hit up again, one after the other in the consecutive crowd control. Seraph teleporting in, 5-2-0, finally joins his team for the first time after just doing his own thing, getting a little help here and there, but playing spectacularly. They go ahead and try to finish Man Cloud. It's going to be a 29-minute game. CLG is on the Nexus. They're going to take down Complexity for the win. Solidly played, nothing special, nothing too wrong. A few mistakes here and there, but that's any game. CLG was able to find the win, pretty much kind of staying away from Complexity.
Well, they used their very strong split-pushing Jax effectively.
Right.
They drew up three people from Complexity to the top side, used their time up. Seraph was able to put out enough damage with the backing from Link. That down bottom, the three-man poke squad was able to just obliterate the two-man defense from Complexity. Even with the teleporting in Westrise to try and clean up three versus three, they get control, just too much speed and too much CC in that three-man squad from CLG.
And this becomes difficult for Complexity. The start of the season is when you want to get your best wins, and it's unfortunate that they had to use a sub today. A lot of the teams that have been playing with their new roster coming in have had the few weeks to bolster up that strength. And now that Complexity finds these losses while still playing strong, you know, the question comes in, what could have happened with the shot?